In this video, we're continuing on with the Simplifying Square Roots worksheet under the Infinite Geometry tab on the KutaSoftware website. Again, I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this worksheet. There's one main tip to remember when simplifying square roots, and that is to find a perfect square that is a multiple within that square root. And I know that sounds a little confusing at first, but practice makes perfect, so let's continue on with number 9. Before we do this, I'm going to write out a couple perfect squares just so that you become more familiar. There's 2 squared, which is 4, 3 squared, 9, 4 squared, 16, 5 squared, 25, 6 squared is 36, 7 squared is 49, and so on. So let's look at number 9. We're trying to simplify the square root of 343. So let's start with 2 squared and see which number goes into 343 evenly. Using a calculator, when we try to divide 343 by 4, 4 does not go into it evenly. So let's try with 9. 9 also doesn't go in evenly. When we try dividing 16 into 343, we get 21 and a decimal. So that doesn't go in evenly. 25, I know just from looking at the number, doesn't go in evenly. Let's try 36. 36 also doesn't go in evenly, so let's try 49. 49 does go in evenly. 49 times 7 equals 343. So the square root of 343 equals the square root of 49 times 7, since 49 times 7 equals 343. And since that 49 is a perfect squared, we can rewrite that as 7 squared. And when it's under the square root, we'll have 7 squared times 7 equals that 343. Now let's break this up into 2 separate radicals. We'll have the square root of 7 squared times the square root of 7. Now you should know that the square root can cancel out that exponent of 2. So the square root of 7 squared is going to be equal to 7 when we simplify, and we still have to multiply that 7 by the square root of 7. So in number 9, 7 times the square root of 7 is our solution. Let's move on to number 10. Number 10 is an easy one to do mentally. We know that 4 goes into 12 evenly. 4 times 3 is 12, so the square root of 12 equals the square root of 4 times 3. That 4 is our perfect square, 2 squared. So we can rewrite that as 2 squared. So now, the square root of 12, we have written as the square root of 2 squared times 3. Breaking up that square root into 2 separate square roots, we have the square root of 2 squared times the square root of 3, which can simplify to be 2 times the square root of 3. So our answer in number 10 is 2 times the square root of 3. Number 11, we already have a whole number outside, but we still have to simplify that square root of 96. If you remember from a previous problem, we found out that 16 was indeed a multiple of 96. 16, which is 4 squared, goes into 96 6 times. So we can rewrite 96 as 16 times 6. So the square root of 96 is equal to the square root of 16 times 6. Since 16 times 6 equals 96, but we're multiplying that whole thing by 10. So we have 10 times the square root of 16 times 6, and that's equal to 10 times the square root of 96. Now we have to rewrite that 16 as 4 squared so we can pull out that whole number. So we have 10 times the square root of 4 squared times 6. Breaking up that radical, we can say 10 times the square root of 4 squared times the square root of 6, and then let's pull out that 4. So we'll have 10 times 4, since the square root of 4 squared is equal to 4, times the square root of 6. 10 times 4 equals 40, and we're left with multiplying 40 by the square root of 6. So for number 11, 40 times the square root of 6 is a simplified version of 10 times the square root of 96. And that's because there's no perfect square that can go into 6. That's how we know we're in our simplest form. Let's go on to number 12. And number 12, again, it starts us with a whole number outside of the radical, but we're still doing the same steps to that square root. So we'll have 9 times the square root of, let's see what goes into 245 evenly. 4 is not a multiple, 9 is not a multiple, 16 is not a multiple, 25 is not a multiple, 36 is not a multiple, but 49 is a multiple. 49 times 5 equals 245. So the square root of 49 times 5 equals the square root of 245. And we're multiplying each of those by 9. So 9 times the square root of 245 is equivalent to 9 times the square root of 49 times 5. So rewriting that 49, we can write that as 7 squared, and we still have times 5 within the radical. Breaking that up, we'll have 9 times the square root of 7 squared times the square root of 5. We can pull out that whole number 7, since the square root of 7 squared equals 7. So we'll have 9 times 7 times the square root of 5. There's no perfect square that is a multiple of 5, so we know that the square root is now in simplest form, and we can just say 9 times 7 is 63. So we'll have 63 times the square root of 5 as our solution. And if you want to double check, go ahead and enter 9 times the square root of 245 on your calculator and see if that equals 63 times the square root of 5. When I enter 9 times the square root of 245 into my calculator, I get 140 in approximately 87 hundredths. And when I enter in 63 times the square root of 5, I indeed get 140 and 87 hundredths. So you can see that both are equivalent. The simplified version is equal to the original. Moving on to number 13, we have 7 times the square root of 600. We can rewrite this as 7 times the square root of 100 times 6, because 100 is 10 squared. So 7 times the square root of 10 squared times 6, we can write that as 7 times the square root of 10 squared times the square root of 6, which the square root of 10 squared is 10. So we'll have 7 times 10 times the square root of 6, which 7 times 10 equals 70, and then we're multiplying that by the square root of 6. So 70 square root of 6 is a solution in number 13. And again, remember, the more familiar you become with perfect squares, the easier it is to decide which perfect square to use. But let's say you didn't recognize that 100 was a perfect square and that 100 went into 600 evenly. Let's say we used 25. Then we would have had 7 times the square root of 25 times 24. So we could have rewritten this as 7 times the square root of 5 squared times the square root of 24, 7 times 5 times the square root of 24, which was 35 times the square root of 24. And then you'd be able to see that 4 goes into 24 evenly. So from there, I'll rewrite 35 square root of 24 on the top. We'd be able to say that that's equivalent to 35 times the square root of 4 times 6, which we know is 35 times the square root of 2 squared times the square root of 6, which we would have 35 times 2, since the square root of 2 squared is 2, times the square root of 6, which eventually would have got us to 70 times the square root of 6. So you can see that we still got to the same solution, it just took a little extra work. So the more familiar you become with your perfect squares just helps in the long run. Number 14, we have 5 times the square root of 45. I know that 9 is a multiple of 45, and 9 is also a perfect square. So I'm going to rewrite this problem as 5 times the square root of 9 times 5, since 9 times 5 is equal to 45. So as opposed to having 5 times the square root of 9 times 5, I'll write that as 5 times the square root of 3 squared times 5. Then I can split up that radical. 5 times the square root of 3 squared times the square root of 5. The square root of 3 squared is 3, so I'll have 5 times 3 times the square root of 5. I know that there's no perfect square that can go into 5 evenly, so all I have left to do is multiply 5 times 3, which is 15, and then multiply that by the square root of 5. So 15 times the square root of 5 is my solution in number 14. Now, continuing on to number 15, we have to figure out what perfect square can go into 180. So 4 does indeed go into 180 evenly. That would be 4 times 45. 4 is my perfect square, so I'll write this as 5 times the square root of 2 squared times 45. I'll be able to pull that whole number 2 out and have 5 times 2 times the square root of 45. Because when I break up that radical, the square root of 2 squared is equal to 2, and then I'm multiplying that by the square root of 45. 5 times 2 is 10, so I have 10 times the square root of 45. However, I know that there's another perfect square that can go into 45, and that perfect square is 9. So I'm going to rewrite 10 times the square root of 45 as 10 times the square root of 9 times 5, since 9 times 5 equals 45. I can rewrite this as 10 times the square root of 3 squared times 5, and when I break up that radical and simplify, I can get that whole number outside of the square root, so it'll be 10 times 3 times the square root of 5, since the square root of 3 squared is 3. 10 times 3 is 30, and I'll have 30 times the square root of 5 as my final solution in 15, since there is no perfect square that can go into 5. And again, if you were able to recognize, 36 also goes into 180 evenly. 36 goes into 180 5 times, and 36 is also a perfect square. So as opposed to having to simplify twice, you would have only had to simplify once if you knew that 36 was multiple. Let's go on to number 16. In number 16, we have 3 times the square root of 405. 4 does not go into 405 evenly, but 9 does. So we have 3 times the square root of 9 times 45, since 9 times 45 equals 405. Now we know that 9 is our perfect square of 3 squared. However, there's another perfect square that can go into 45. So as opposed to simplifying and then looking at the multiples of 45, let's look at them right now. So we'll rewrite 3 times the square root of 9. We know that 45 is equal to 9 times 5. So now, as opposed to having 3 times the square root of 9 times 45, we have 3 times the square root of 9 times 9 times 5. 9 times 45 is the same as 9 times 9 times 5. 9 and 9 are now our perfect squares. So let's rewrite both of those. So we'll have 3 times the square root of 3 squared times 3 squared times 5. Let's break up this radical. We'll have 3 times the square root of 3 squared times the square root of 3 squared times the square root of 5. And as we saw up here, there's no perfect square that can go into 5. So this is going to be the square root that's multiplied to the whole number. So we'll have 3 times 3 times 3 times the square root of 5, since the square root of 3 squared is 3, and the square root of 3 squared is 3. 3 times 3 times 3, 3 times 3 is 9, 9 times 3 is 27. So 27 times the square root of 5 is our final solution in number 16. Continue on in the next video, where I'll finish out simplifying square root worksheet. Before you do that, however, please remember to like this video and subscribe to my channel. And if you have any questions or comments, please feel free to leave them below. Also, if you haven't noticed, I'm trying to show you many different ways to simplify square roots, whether that's finding the largest perfect square or using the smallest perfect square and continuing to simplify. Please use whatever you feel more comfortable with.